come on, you know the song.
You got the touch! You got the power!
Behold, the Optimus Prime figure, supposedly to top all other mainline Optimus figures. Studio Series 86 Movie Commander Class Optimus Prime. To summarize, Optimus Prime, Autobot leader and awesome dude, turns into a big semi-truck, a literal icon in action figures, TV, comic books, and movies. Killed in the 1986 animated movie by thoughtless writers who only wanted to clear the decks so they could shoehorn Rodimus Prime in as his replacement. A ploy that failed miserably as Optimus Prime was brought back by an outpouring of fan protest, becoming perhaps the first Transformers character to gain figurative immunity from me. Brought back again, and again, and again across many toy lines, films, and TV shows, there's no denying he has carved his niche in the edifice of time. And now he comes to the Studio Series 86 line of figures, in what is purportedly his best version ever. Is that the case? We shall see. Behold his box with big You've Got the Touch splash art on the front, and some pics of the figure tossed in as well. Big Check Me Out art on the side panel. More photos of both modes and the accessories on the back, along with his bio reading. Optimus Prime joins the Autobot City defense to stop the Decepticons, no matter the cost. Cecil B. DeMille close-up on the other side panel. And now, let's get this figure out of his box and see if he's got the touch.
You got the touch!
Out of box, Studio Series 86 Commander Class Optimus Prime comes with his instruction booklet, his ion rifle weapon, the six-wheeled roller buggy, a repair bay drone, two fire blast accessories, an energon axe, four pieces which assemble the You've Got the Touch boosters, and of course the trailer accessory. And don't forget the normal Studio Series cardboard backdrop diorama, depicting the battle scene at Autobot City from the movie. And let's deal with the main question right away. This Commander-class figure is actually much smaller than other Commander figures, like Siege Jetfire or Studio Series 86 Ultra Magnus. And yes, Hasbro made up for it by dumping a load of accessories into the box, which you may or may not use depending on your preferences. But before going on to the main event, let's nibble at the appetizers, starting with the trailer. It's neatly colored, and the plastic certainly feels good and solid. There's a hitch at the front where you can attach Optimus Prime in truck mode, or attach the roller buggy. There's a flip-down pair of struts to keep the trailer level when there's no vehicle attached. And if that wasn't enough, there are these fold-out extendo struts. There are only four pinned-in wheels at the back, with silver hubcaps. They're connected to a hidden compartment where you store the You've Got the Touch fire blast pieces when those aren't in use. The back door of the trailer swings down, and the trailer is large enough that you can fit in two deluxe-sized figures, or three to four legend-sized figures. And yes, the trailer will split open like a loaf of plastic bread. The interior isn't painted, but there's a lot of sculpted detailing. And if you want to try your hand at applying paint and ruining the resale value, well, there's nothing stopping you. The interior is loaded with tabs and pegs where you can plug in the gun, the fire blasts, the axe, the repair drone, and roller for storage. Though not necessarily in that order. Flip up the door, stand the trailer up vertically, and it doubles as Optimus Prime's repair bay, or his coffin, if you want to reenact his temporary death scene from the movie. There are two slots under the front bumper, where you can attach roller to the repair bay, so it won't slide around inside the truck when it's closed up. The roller buggy has six pinned black wheels, all plastic, no vinyl rubber, done over in silver. It has two 5mm ports on top, where you can attach the gun, or the repair bay drone. Both the front and back seats can be fitted with Titan Master or Headmaster minifigures, so they can beep beep around the battlefield, cruising for fembots. The repair drone is a tri-folding armature done in blue and gray plastic. It folds here, and here, and here to go compact, and has two 5mm pegs on the base, so it can plug into the roller buggy or any open 5mm port on any other figure. There's a double-hinged swivel-out repair arm, with opening and closing claw. Also a soft ratcheted fold-up, spatula. And in front of that, a pop-open translucent blue canopy where you can fit absolutely nothing. But it was nice that they threw it in.
Maybe you can make a little planner out of it or something.
And up at the front are two mini fire blast pegs, where the floppy lightsaber-shaped fire blasts can be plugged in to terrify the Decepticons with their limpness. As you can tell, they're made out of the softer, bendable plastic. It'll take a hairdryer and some reshaping to get them to go straight. Peg it into the trailer for storage. The top can also swivel 360 degrees. Or top off the repair bay, where it can give Optimus Prime a deep tissue massage. As for the alt mode itself, is there really anything to be said about what it is? Semi-truck. Red. What else is there, really? And yes, the colors here are red in the front, blue in the back, with silver bumpers, grills, and gas tanks, and some yellow splashed on the headlights. The rearview mirrors are also silver. All the tires are pinned with silver hubcaps, though there is no vinyl rubber treads to give them any grip. They are hard plastic, and they will slide instead of rolling if the surface is too slick. And not all the tires seem to touch the ground evenly, at least on my copy, meaning some of them won't spin at all. The windows seem to be clear, with pearly blue panels layered underneath, which gives the windows the illusion of depth. In terms of the engineering, everything seems to tab together tight and evenly. Nothing seems to pull loose unless you pull it loose. The exception are the silver smokestacks, which seem to spin freely. When you're transforming or posing the figure, you're bound to find the smokestacks to be out of alignment. The heft of it feels good in hand, though there are no other gimmicks in and of itself. It's a toy truck, but it fills that role well. So Optimus Prime can roll out. Get it? Roll? Roll? Anywho, there are ways you can customize him. Most of the weapons only store inside the trailer, but you can plug the gun into the back. Your first instinct would probably be to try and jam the 5mm peg into the very obvious open port, but that won't work. No, there are these square pegs a bit further up, and you push the gun handle into either one of those. So unless you use different accessories from other figures, the only thing that will peg into the 5mm port is the trailer itself. This flimsy connection lets Optimus Prime bulk up to true Commander class heft by adding the weight of the trailer and all of its accessories to his overall mass. And there's enough space behind the truck engine that you can steer it well while you're pushing it around. Because pushing is the only way this thing will move on its own. Whee! There are no mini ports in the alt mode for pegging in fire blasts or the axe. The only other accessories you can use are the You've Got the Touch fire blasts. Each one has two pieces that must be pegged together, and the assembled fire blasts then peg underneath the front bumper like so. They're notched so they should fit in only one way, and this elevates Optimus Prime to make him look like he's turbo jumping. All of this was a long, convoluted path that Hasbro took so buyers could replicate barely 2 seconds worth of footage from the 86 movie. Was it worth it?
You got the touch! You got the power!
Power!
This figure can also be said to be the 40th anniversary version of Optimus Prime, which is appropriate because its transformation instructions list 40 steps. First, deaccessorize, then rotate and invert the rear tires. Untap the section just behind the front wheel, It untabs and swings down. At the same time, use a mushroom peg to rotate the front half so that the red portions are hidden and the blue portion exposed. Then continue the rotation until each panel is fully inverted. When transforming to alt mode, there is a tab on the inside of the blue portion that pegs into this slot on the robot thigh. The platform behind Optimus Prime has these two panels which peg into the red portions at the back. Untab them and swing them up. Invert them and tab them down. Flip up the heel spurs. Flip forward the toes. Underneath the truck, there is this panel here which must be untabbed and swiveled up. Then, very much like the original Generation 1 figure, the entire leg assembly folds forward, and this round portion here goes into this indentation. Flip down Optimus Prime's butt flaps. Untab the legs and split them apart. The feet have these little tabs which stick out so that you can peg the legs together for the alt mode. Fold those inward so that they're out of the way when he is in robot mode. These panels untab from the inside of the shins. They fold up, and this slot and groove marry up to tab them together, and repeat for both sides. And yes, if you really want to, you can girl-walk him in this mode. Tra-la-la-la-la-la-la-la. Moving to the truck body, these panels fold down from the side to reveal his innards. Once these panels have been folded down, there is a sub-panel towards the back that must be inverted and tabbed in. Continue folding these panels until they are all the way down. They should slip in just behind the bumper. Sometimes it's easier to unfold the chest panel so that you can do this next step, because opening the chest gives you easier access to fold down this panel. Once this panel opens like a drawbridge, it is hinged in the middle. Fold it in half, then fold it back up, and this entire assembly to the front cab folds down on a hidden hinge set on the inside. And in another step that harks back to the original Generation 1 figure, Optimus Prime's arms untab from back here. They continue to fold and swivel out, and then push and tab into the robot chest. For the alt mode, you can know the arms are in the right place because they tab in right here. Swivel the arm portions up and out of the way. Then just underneath his armpits, there are these things. They fold out and up. Up towards the roof of the truck, there is this thing that juts out. Like most of the parts, it's hinged in the middle, rotated up and out of the way. Then there are these sections here which form Prime's obliques. They tab together and are double hinged down here. Hinge them out so that they splay apart. Then take this section which folds down to reveal a false grill which form his mighty abs. His entire midsection is supposed to swivel and rotate independently of the top half and the bottom half, doing 180 degree rotation so that the ab section matches up with his freshly revealed underpants. Then hold that section completely in place and rotate the top half so that the chest and the abs match up again. Then you can fold these flaps back down, which fills up his midsection. This tab here and this groove here are supposed to meet up. You'll have to angle things a bit until they line up and tab together. And you've probably guessed that Optimus Prime's head folds out from the inside. And gosh darn it, you're right. Rotate his head until this panel lines up and flattens. One thing that isn't mentioned in the instruction is that Optimus Prime's antenna will rotate. When transforming to alt mode, you won't be able to fit the head back here until you rotate out the antenna forward a little. But when transforming to robot mode, you can go ahead and straighten them up like they're supposed to be. One easy step to miss is that underneath the headlights there are these little fold-in panels. Flip those in, and then the assembly which was the front of the truck tabs into the slot just behind his back. The bumper slips underneath, and this red tab goes into this groove just behind his neck. Folding in those little tabs also helps to complete his midsection. Make sure this tab is folded up and out of the way, then invert the front wheel sections until they meet up in the back. Then a double hinge set collapses this tiny red panel up on top of it all, and cinches it all together. Don't laugh, but dangling underneath Optimus Prime's butt is this fold-up blue section. Fold it up and tab it into the back of his butt. Fold down each arm. Then on the inside of each forearm is this fold-out panel. Open it up and it reveals his fold-out fists. Flip them out. Then reclose. Then the arms rotate and invert. You'll know they're rotated in the right direction. Once the hidden pause and play buttons are exposed, rotate the fists so that they are the right side up, and complete the transformation. The unspoken truth about Optimus Prime's animation model is that they were compelled to make alterations away from the 1986 action figure. Otherwise, the animated version would have looked, well, lousy. The toy had certain physical constraints, which meant nothing to the animators. For example, the way his front fender would squash and morph to become his crotch. Also removing the wheel wells from his forearms, so they would be easier to draw rectangles. There was also that weird blue tail fin just behind his robot, which never existed on the toy. The toy had chrome thighs and pelvis, but shiny metal is just too hard for the animators to draw, don't you know? So the animators made them white. And that's what they did here, too. All the little tweaks which the animators used to bring Optimus Prime into the 80s cartoon series were deliberately engineered into the Studio Series 86 action figure. So there's some kind of cosmic synchrony in the fact that the 86 animators took the toy and altered its appearance for their animation model, but now Hasbro has taken the animation model and altered the toy to match that. All that aside, Studio Series 86 Commander Class Optimus Prime is perhaps the closest match to the animated series that you will ever see. Save perhaps in the masterpiece line, it proportions well, with neither the head nor the legs seeming too long or too stumpy. He features his iconic head, with air vent at the front, antenna at the sides, and the faceplate. One thing they didn't do was light piping, but for once, the eyes are not recessed too far into the back, so you can actually see his baby blues instead of gazing into a fathomless black pit. There's the truck windows for his pecs, with flashlights on top, silver smokestacks on the shoulders, forearms with the pause and play buttons molded into them, his blue butt tail fin, simulated bumper crotch, white underpants and thighs, and shins with gas tanks on them. One thing that may seem out of place is the backpack, which is thicker than the animated movie showed, but they had to stuff all the truck exterior parts somewhere, and a backpack was as good a place as any. But front to back, top to bottom, Studio Series Optimus Prime is nice and solid with no hollow gaps. By itself, the figure weighs 7.9 ounces. He is slightly larger, with more heft as well, so even though it's small for a Commander class, he will have more shelf presence than a normal Voyager. And customizing options? Sure, why not? Do the transformation step of folding out the forearm, refold in the fist, re-clamp shut, and it exposes a small nub at the end of his forearm, where you can plug in the floppy rubber Energon axe for tree chopping and poking action. It can be done to either arm, and either hand can also hold the ion rifle, the end of which can be fitted with one of the limp noodle fire blast effects. The backpack has these little tabs sticking out to the side, which is where you plug in the ion rifle for storage, and since the holding tabs have migrated to the top of the backpack, you can still plug in the You've Got the Touch fire blasts just behind his shoulders if you really want to. And he just wouldn't be Optimus Prime if you couldn't open his pecs, flip up this gray panel, to reveal a cubbyhole wherein the matrix of leadership is stashed. Yes, it's removable. And yes, the articulation joints are set up so that you can pose Optimus Prime to hold the matrix in the classic posture of lighting our darkest hour. There are no other open 5mm ports on this figure except for one beneath each big toe. You can almost squeeze the You've Got the Touch fire blasts below his feet, but the way they're sculpted, they just don't hold in well enough to make it look like he's rocketing up with the power of awesome. And don't forget you can still stand him inside his repair bay. The articulation is certainly excellent. Starting with the head, the antenna can be tilted forward and back. The head is on a ball socket. It will rotate all the way, but it will only waggle a little bit to the left and to the right, and waggle a little up and down. You have to release the transformation hinges to get any real neck motion out of him. The smokestacks swivel a little too easily. Each arm will do a full rotation, splay outward, upper bicep swivel, a 90-degree elbow bend, each fist will spin freely, and he has articulated fingers. The top fingers are double-jointed and will curl, and the bottom three fingers, though joined together, are also double-jointed with curling action. Full 360-degree waist rotation. If you flip up the hip skirts and the butt flap, the legs will kick forwards this far, backwards just as far. They will splay outward. There's an upper thigh swivel. Each knee will bend over 90 degrees. The feet tab into these little flaps at the side, but you can untab them to get that ankle pivot. Also, because of the transformation, the toes will fold downward, and the heel spurs will also fold down. The heel and toe spurs allow for some good balancing, but could still really use a forward tilt. An ab crunch and being able to nod the head would also have helped. But whether you're trying to replicate poses from the movie, or just goof around, Studio Series Commando Class Optimus Prime is ready to play along. You got the touch! Time to compare sizes. Here is Studio Series 86 Movie Commander Class Optimus Prime next to the original Generation 1 Optimus Prime. No blue butt plug. Here is 86 Commander Class Optimus Prime next to Legacy United Voyager Transformers Animated Optimus Prime. Here is 86 Commander Class Optimus Prime next to Studio Series Rise of the Beasts Voyager Optimus Prime. Here is Earthrise Voyager / Leader Optimus Prime, who is being replaced by Studio Series 86 Commander Optimus Prime. Sorry, Earthrise. And here is Studio Series 86 Commander Class Optimus Prime, next to this Mr. Clean Magic Eraser Kitchen Sponge. I have picked up a number of Optimus Prime figures over the course of time, and while I won't immediately pounce on just any Optimus figure, I've acquired enough that they have their own shelf. So the question becomes, is Studio Series 86 Optimus Prime shelf-worthy? And the basic answer is, heck yeah! I believe I've finally found a figure that's good enough to replace Earthrise Voyager Optimus Prime on my Generation 1 Autobot shelf. Positives are that both modes are solid and well-engineered with options for customization. Whether as a truck or a robot, you won't be able to complain that they didn't pay attention to screen accuracy. From the paint applications to the tires, they kept everything consistent with minimal seaming and kibble. The transformation is clever and yields good payback for all the effort that it requires. He's got the axe, the gun, the matrix, the articulation, and the touch. And the set has plenty of homages to prove it. Negatives? Not all that many. There are some sections of the alt mode that could tab together better. The gunfire blasts do an ED thing that's kind of embarrassing. The tires don't roll all that well. The transformation can be frustrating your first couple times through until you get the hang of it. The You've Got the Touch fire blasts serve only one display function, which not everyone may go for. And there's still the chance that some collectors may bristle at yet again being compelled to pretend that a leader-class figure is a commander when it very clearly isn't. They may only be interested in the figure itself and care nothing about having a bulky trailer clogging up their shelf space. But unless you want to pay masterpiece prices, I acknowledge this to be the best mainline figure I've seen yet. I give Studio Series 86 Commander Class Optimus Prime 9 out of 10 deaths. It's an item that any Optimus Prime collector should have, no matter the cost.
No matter the cost. You got the touch! You got the power!